Blue Star High Secondary School video classes for 9th standard mathematics. Happy morning students. Last video we see exercise 6.5. Today we are going to see a new unit, unit 7, mensuration. Before we are going to the problems, we have to see some formulas. Let us see the formulas one by one. Unit 7, mensuration, formulae. First one, area of a triangle, A is equal to, we know the formula, half into base into height. We represent base as B and height as H. Therefore, the area of a triangle formula is equal to half into B into H square units. Then second one, if A comma B and C are the sides of a triangle, if we doesn't know the base and height, only they given the side values of the triangle, we have to use the formula. This is nothing but the Heron's formula. So area of a triangle is equal to root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C square units, where S is equal to the sides A plus B plus C divided by 2, where S is the semi perimeter of the triangle. Next formula is, third one is cuboid. You know cuboid is a 3D figure. First one is lateral surface area of the cuboid. So you have to find the lateral surface area of the cuboid. This formula is nothing but 2 into L plus B into H square units. So cuboid, it is a 3 dimensional figure. So it has length, breadth and height too. Then next one is total surface area. So total surface area is equal to 2 into LB plus BH plus LH into square units. Then third one is volume of the cuboid. So volume of the cuboid is equal to length into breadth into height cubic units. So let us see what is lateral surface area and what is total surface area in the cuboid. So cuboid is a closed solid sphere bounded by 6 rectangular plane regions. We know, for example, matchbox, brick, books are all example for cuboid. So a cuboid has 6 faces, 12 edges and 8 vertices. So the total surface area, that is TSA of the cuboid, is the sum of the areas of all the faces that enclose the cuboids. So இப்போ ஒரு cuboid அப்படின்னு எடுத்தோம் அப்படின்னா இது அதோட வேர்டெக்ஸ், இதுதான் அதோட ஃபேஸ். ஸோ இதில் இருக்கிற 6 ஃபேஸஸ் எல்லாத்தையும் டோட்டலாக பார்த்தோம் அப்படின்னா அதுதான் நம்மளோட டோட்டல் சர்ஃபேஸ் ஏரியா. இஃப் வி லீவ் அவுட் த ஏரியாஸ் ஆஃப் த டாப் அண்ட் பாட்டம் ஆஃப் த cuboid, வி கெட் தட் இஸ் நோன் அஸ் த லேட்ரல் சர்ஃபேஸ் ஏரியா. ஸோ ஒரு cuboidல அதோட டாப் அண்ட் பாட்டமை மட்டும் நம்ம விட்டுட்டு ரிமைனிங் பார்ட்ஸ் எல்லாத்தையுமே கன்க்ளூட் பண்ணோன்னா அது அதோட லேட்ரல் சர்ஃபேஸ் ஏரியா அப்படின்னு சொல்கிறாங்க. ஸோ இதோட ஃபார்முலா தான் நம்ம பார்த்தோம். ஸோ லேட்ரல் சர்ஃபேஸ் ஏரியா ஆஃப் த cuboid அண்ட் டோட்டல் சர்ஃபேஸ் ஏரியா ஆஃப் த cuboid. நெக்ஸ்ட் ஃபோர்த் ஒன், கியூப். ஸோ லேட்ரல் சர்ஃபேஸ் ஏரியா ஆஃப் த கியூப் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 4a ஸ்கொயர் ஸ்கொயர் யூனிட்ஸ். தென் டோட்டல் சர்ஃபேஸ் ஏரியா ஆஃப் த கியூப் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 6a ஸ்கொயர் ஸ்கொயர் யூனிட்ஸ். தென் வால்யூம் ஆஃப் அ கியூப் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு a கியூப் கியூபிக் யூனிட்ஸ். Already we seen in the second formula, by using the sides of the triangle we write the area of a triangle formula, that is nothing but Heron's formula. So Heron is a mathematician. He gave a formula for finding the area of a triangle if the height is not known but the length of the 3 sides are known. If A comma B comma C denote the sides of BC comma AC and AB respectively of a triangle ABC, then area of a triangle is equal to root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C, where S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2. So this formula is only used for finding the area of a triangle whose sides is given. First we are going to see the example problem, example 7.1, which is in page number 249. The length of sides of a triangular field are 28 meter, 15 meter and 41 meter. Calculate the area of the field Find the cost of leveling the field at the rate of rupees 20 per meter square. So the length of the sides, that is length of the sides of a triangular field is given 28, 15 and 41. You have to calculate the area of the field. That is nothing but you have to find the area of a triangle. After that, you have to find the cost of leveling the field at the rate of rupees 20 per meter square. So solution, let the sides of the triangle, that is A is equal to 28 meter, B is equal to 15 meter and C is equal to 41 meter. Then we know how to find the semi-perimeter of a triangle. That is S is equal to A plus B plus C divided by 2, which is equal to 28 plus 15 plus 41 by 2. So 28 plus 15 plus 41 by 2, which is equal to, if you add 28 plus 15 plus 41, you get 84 divided by 2. So 84 divided by 2 is nothing but 42 meter. That is S is equal to 42 meter. Now only we find the value of X. Next we have to find the area of the triangle. So area of the triangular field is equal to root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C, which is equal to root of S value is 42 into 42 minus A is 28. Then 42 minus B value is 15 and 42 minus C value is 41, which is equal to root of 42 into 42 minus 28 is 14 into 42 minus 15 is 27 into 42 minus 41 is 1, which is equal to, the next step is you have to know the prime factorization. So you have to take the prime factorization for 42, 14, 27. You have to do this in your rough column. So prime factorization for 42 is 2 times 21, again 3 times 7 threes are 21, then 7 times 1. Then prime factorization of 14 is 2 table, so 7 times, again 7 times 1. Then 27, 3 table, 9 threes are 27, again 3 table, 3 times, so 3 times 1. So you can write root 42 as 2 into 3 into 7. So 2 into 3 into 7. Then 14 as 2 into 7. Then 27 as 3 into 3 into 3 into 1. So now we can take out the square root. So root of, we have 2, so 2 square into, out of this 2 you have to write 2 square, then 3 square into 7 square into, again you have 3 square, so which is nothing but 2 into 3 into 7 into 3, which is nothing but 126 meter square. Now given in the question, the cost of leveling is rupees 20 per meter square. Therefore, the total cost of leveling the field is equal to 20 into area of the triangular field, that is 126 meter square, which is equal to rupees 2520. So the cost of leveling the field is rupees 2520 rupees. Next one is example 7.2, which is in page number 250. Three different rectangular flats are available for sale in a locality. So each plot has a perimeter of 120 meter. The side length are also given. So first one is shape of the plot, second one is perimeter, and third one is length of the sides. So right angle triangle, the first plot is right angle triangle, its perimeter is 120 meter and their sides is 30 meter, 40 meter, 50 meter. Then next one is acute angled triangle, its perimeter is 120 meter and the length of the sides is 35 meter, 40 meter and 45 meter. Then the third rectangular plot, that is the shape of that plot is equilateral triangle, its perimeter is 120 meter then the length of the sides is 40 meter 40 meter and 40 meter. Because if it is a equilateral triangle, means all the sides are equal. So you have to help the buyer to decide which among this will be more spacious. So solution, for clarity, let us draw a rough figure indicating the measurement. So these are the three figures. First one is right angled triangle, which is right angled at B. So A is, AB is, that is length of the first side is 30 meter, 40 meter and 50 meter. Second one is acute angled triangle. This side is 35 meter, 40 meter and 45 meter. Then the third one is equilateral triangle. All the sides ABC are equal, that is 40 meter. So first you have to find the semi-perimeter for the each triangle, and then you have to find the area of the triangle. Then by comparing the area of the triangle of the three given triangle, which one is more spacious, we can find it easily. First we are taking the right angled triangle, which is right angled at B. Then A is 30 meter, B is 40 meter, C is 50 meter. That is semi-perimeter S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2, which is equal to 30 plus 40 plus 50 divided by 2, which is equal to 120 by 2, which is nothing but S is equal to 60. Or otherwise, in the question itself, they already given the perimeter of all the shape of the plot is 120 meter. So from that we can directly find S is equal to 60 meter. Then the area of the triangle using the Herron's formula, which is equal to root of S into S minus A, S minus B into S minus C, which is equal to root of, the value of S is 60. So 60 into 60 minus 30, that is A value, and 60 minus 40, B is 40, and 60 minus 50, that is C is 50, which is equal to root of 60 into 60 minus 30 is 30, 60 minus 40 is 20, and 60 minus 50 is 10. The next step is you have to take the prime factorization, or we can split directly also. So we can split 60 as 30 into 2, and here you can write 30 as directly. So 30 into 2 as, sorry, 20 as 2 into 10. So 2 tens are 20 into, already you have 110. So which is nothing but root of 30 square into 2 square into 10 square, which is equal to, then square and square root gets cancelled. So you get 30 into 2 into 10, which is nothing but 30 into 2 is 60, 60 into 10 is 600, which is equal to 600 meter square. Therefore, area of the triangle, area of the right angled triangle is 600 meter square. Next one is acute angled triangle. So acute angled triangle, one side is 35 meter, then the side B is 40 meter, then side C is 45 meter. Semi-perimeter S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2, which is equal to 35 plus 40 plus 45, which is equal to 120 by 2, which is equal to S is nothing but 60 meter. Next you have to find area of the triangle. So which is equal to root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C, which is equal to root of S value is 60, 60 into 60 minus 35, then 60 minus 40 and 60 minus 45, which is equal to root of 60 into 60 minus 35 is 25, 60 minus 40 is 20, 60 minus 45 is 15, which is equal to, we can split 30 as, sorry, 60 as 20 into 3 into 25 as 5 5s are 25 into 20 as it is into 15 is 5 3s are 15. So which is equal to root of 20 square into 3 square into 5 square into you have 1 5, which is equal to 20 into 3 into 5 root 5. The next step is you have to multiply 20 into 3, you get 60. 60 into 5, you get 300 into root 5. So you can stop up to this, or otherwise the value for root 5 is 2.236. So if you multiply 300 with 2.236, you get the area of a triangle is 670.8 meter square. Therefore, area of the acute angle triangle is 670.8 meter square. Then third subdivision is equilateral triangle. So in an equilateral triangle, all sides are equal. So semi-perimeter S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2, which is equal to 40 plus 40 plus 40 by 2, which is equal to 120 by 2. So S is equal to 60 meter. Then area of a triangle is equal to root of S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C, which is equal to root of 60 into 60 minus 40 into 60 minus 40 into 60 minus 40, which is equal to root of 60 into 20 into 20 into 20, which is equal to root of 3 into 20. We can split 60 as 3 to 6, so 3 into 20 into, already you have 20 into 20 into 20. So which is equal to root of 3 into 20 square into 20 square. We can take 20, 20 outside. So 20 into 20 into root 3, which is equal to 20 into 20 is 400 root 3. You know root 3 value is 1.732. So if you multiply 400 with 1.732, you get the value 692.8 meter square. So now we find the area of a equilateral triangle is 692.8 meter square. Therefore, comparing area of a right angle triangle and acute angle triangle and equilateral triangle, you get area of the right angle triangle is equal to 600 meter square, area of acute angle triangle is equal to 670.8 meter square, and area of a equilateral triangle is equal to 692.8 meter square. So comparing these three, area of the equilateral triangle is bigger, that is 692.8 meter square. Equilateral triangle is more spacious comparing with other two triangles. Next one is example 7.3, page number 252. A farmer has a field is the shape of a rhombus. The perimeter of the field is 400 meter and one of its diagonal is 120 meter. He wants to divide the field into two equal parts to grow two different types of vegetables. Find the area of the field. So assuming that the area of the field is in the shape of a rhombus, so you have to divide, that is you have to draw one line through the diagonal. So here AC is the diagonal, that meter is 120 meter. So the sides of the rhombus is 100 meter. So let ABCD be the rhombus. Its perimeter is equal to 4 into side, that is nothing but 4A. So which is equal to 4 into 100 is equal to 400 meter. So its perimeter is 400 meter. Therefore, each side of the rhombus is equal to 100 meter. Given the length of the diagonal AC is equal to 120 meters given in the question. So in the triangle ABC, A is equal to 100 meter, B is equal to 100 meter and C is equal to 120 meter. That is one side of the plot. So here A is 100 and B is also 100 and C is the third side, that is 120, that is nothing but the diagonal of the rhombus. S is equal to, we know the formula, A plus B plus C by 2, which is equal to 100 plus 100 plus 120 divided by 2, which is equal to 320 by 2. Therefore, the semi-perimeter S is equal to 160 meter. Next, you have to find the area of the triangle. So, area of a triangle is equal to root of S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C, which is equal to root of value of S is 160. So, 160 minus A is 100. Again, 160 minus B value is 100. Then, 160 minus C value is 120, which is equal to root of 160 into 60 into 60 into 40. Which is equal to root of, we can split for 160 as 40 into 2, into 2, because 40 into 2, 2s are 4, so 4, 4s are 16, so 4 into 40 is 160 into 60 into 60 into 40, so which is nothing but you can write 40 square, so 40 into 2 square is 2 into 60, which is nothing but 4800 meter square. Therefore, area of a triangle is nothing but 4800 meter square. So, next you have to find the area of the field. Now we find only the one side of the field, that is nothing but in a triangular shape. So you have to find the area of a one triangle. Then you have to find the area of the whole field. So this is a rhombus. So both the sides are, that is triangle 1 is equal to triangle 2. Therefore, area of the field ABCD, that is rhombus, is equal to 2 into area of a triangle ABC, which is equal to 2 into 4800, which is nothing but 9600 meter square. Therefore, area of the rhombus, that is area of the field, is equal to 9600 meter square. So, thank you students. Up to this, example problems and formulas are over. For the next upcoming videos, we are moving to the exercise 7.1. Thank you students. Have a nice day.